All right, in today's lesson, we're going to be looking at rational inequalities. So in this question here, we're starting off, we have a rational inequality we want to solve. This is involved with absolute values as well. The first property to observe is the following. We have that the absolute value of x over y, that's actually equivalent to absolute value of x over absolute value of y. So applying that property, we have the following. Now that we have this property here, we now know that the absolute value of x minus 6 is always a positive number. So I can multiply across by the absolute value of x minus 6 without changing the direction of our inequality, giving us the following. And now in this situation here, we're going to draw ourselves our number line. And I've got two values of interest here. I have 5 over 2 and 6. And that's going to generate us three inequalities here in this interval, this one, and this one. Let's examine what inequalities exist in each interval and solve them. Examining interval 1 here, we can see that when x is greater than 6, both the left-hand and right-hand side absolute values will be positive. Therefore, I can drop the absolute value and solve the inequality, giving us. And you can see here, I dropped the absolute value on both the expressions. I went ahead and did my distribution, collected like terms. Again, watch out when you divide across to isolate that x by negative 1. I had to change the direction of the inequality. So now my solution set here is going to go from 13 to infinity. Let's take a look at equation 2. In interval 2 here, you'll see the left-hand side absolute value will be positive and the right-hand side will be negative, giving us the following. And solving for this inequality, we end up getting here x is less than 23 over 5. 23 over 5 is in this interval. So that's going to give us a solution set from 5 halves to 23 over 5. So now for our answer set so far, we have greater than 13 and greater than or equal to 5 halves and less than 23 over 5. Continuing here, we look at our third interval, giving us. And in this interval here, going ahead, notice I multiplied across by minus sign. Get rid of that minus sign, I had to switch the inequality direction, and solving, I get x is less than 13, and that is x is less than 13 within this interval, which means the entire interval is true. So therefore, the solution set here for equation 3, or interval 3, I should say, is negative infinity up until 5 halves. So combining these three answers together, the final answer here is negative infinity to 23 over 5, union 13 to infinity. Now again, how I got this is we have our one interval here, 13 to infinity, and combining these two together gives us this complete interval here. Let's take a look at another example. All right, let's take a look at another rational inequality. This one does not have absolute values in it. When assessing rational inequalities, what we want to do here in this case is bring everything to one side and try to get a common denominator. Doing so, we get, go ahead and getting a common denominator here, I end up getting the following. Again, the idea here is by having 0 on the right-hand side, we can now compare this to being positive or negative. So that's a general strategy when solving rational inequalities, is to bring everything to one side and get yourself a common denominator. Now I'm going to go ahead and expand and simplify, giving us. Going ahead here, expanding and simplifying, I end up getting here 2 times x plus 14 on the top. We obviously leave the x minus 6 and x plus 2 alone on the bottom. Going ahead and drawing a number line and examining each interval, we get the following. So taking a look here, I grabbed our intervals here. I've got negative 14. That's going to be a root for our rational function. At negative 2 and 6, we put open circles on those. Those values are undefined, so we want to make sure those are not in our solution set. And now I have four intervals to examine. If you take a look here, anything that I choose greater than 6 is going to result in the top expression being positive, and these will be positive as well. So the three positives will be positive as a result here. So everything in this interval will be positive, i.e. greater than 0. As I go between negative 2 and 6, you'll find this is negative, positive, and negative. And again, that's found just by choosing numbers within each interval, summing it into this expression, and you see the following signs of each interval, i.e. positive, negative in this situation. Now notice how it did oscillate back and forth going between these. The reason for that is the multiplicities at 6, negative 2, and 14, i.e. the vertical asymptotes or the roots, were odd. Had this been a power of 2, let's say, on the minus 14, this would have bounced off that root and it would have continued to be positive. But for this example here, we have the following. So I'm interested in knowing when is this going to be greater than 0. Greater than 0 is going to happen from negative 14 until negative 2, union 6 to infinity. And this becomes our answer for the following. Let's take a look at another rational equation when we get multiplicities that are even. So let's take a look at the following question here. Identify the values here that we want to examine on our number line. So I've got a minus 1, I have a 2, and a 3. At the minus 1 and the 3, we're going to put open circles on that as it is undefined. Now, if we pick any number greater than 3, you'll notice this question, it's already factored for us, already cleaned up, so we can go right to the analysis. If I pick anything greater than 3, we're going to have a positive number, and a positive number. Therefore, this will be positive in this interval. Now, in this case here, as I tend towards the 3 here, the next expression is going to bounce off that value, and it's going to be positive once again. And then as I tend towards the 2 here, you'll see the multiplicity on this is odd, so it's going to change signs to be negative. And then as I tend towards the minus 1, back to even, so it's going to keep that same value, in this case negative again. If you're uncomfortable doing it that way, you can just sub in values. Like I could pick any number greater than 3 and sub it in, see whether the result is positive. Again, you pick anything between 2 and 3, like 2.5, you'll see this is positive, positive. And because of that power of 4, that'll be positive as well. And then anything between negative 1 and 2, you'll find it's negative. And anything less than negative 1 is also negative. So I'm interested in knowing when is this greater than 0. That's going to happen from 2 to 3. Open bracket, and again, I can't include the 3 in my solution set as it is undefined. Union 3 to infinity. And this becomes our answer for this example. So in the next example here, same idea. I want to practice this once more time. So in this situation here, again, apply our absolute value rule, giving us the following. Again, multiplying across by the absolute value of 4x plus 1. We know that 4x plus 1, the absolute value of that is positive. That will not change the inequality sign. I also know that x cannot equal, like implicitly this equation is assuming that x cannot equal negative 1/4, else the equation itself would not even exist. So I know this is not 0, and I know that it's in fact greater than 0 with the absolute value on it. So I can multiply across, giving us. Draw your number line here, and the two points of interest are negative 1/4, in this case, and 2. So now we have here three intervals, 1, 2, and 3, and examine the inequality in each one. So for interval 1 here, we're picking values greater than 2. Both of these are positive, in which case if I examine my equation here, I can drop the absolute value in both of these and solve. And I'm getting x is less than minus 1. You'll notice that x is less than minus 1 is not in this interval, so this is inadmissible, and we can't use any of that here. So we've got no information, no solution set so far for our question, and interval 1 gives us nothing. Let's take a look at interval 2. Examining interval 2, we see that the absolute value of x minus 2 is going to be negative, and this will be positive, so I can drop the absolute value here on the left and have to multiply by a minus sign. That is not the case on the right. Solving, we get. All right, so solving for this here, I get x is less than minus 1/5. So my answer here, we have to watch out a bit. Recall the minus 1/4 is inadmissible. It's undefined there, right? The original equation did not exist when x equals negative 1/4. So the solution here for interval 2 is going to go from negative 1/4 open bracket on that, because you don't want to include that, to that negative 1/5. Let's now take a look at interval number 3. Taking a look at interval number 3 here, both the left and right-hand side absolute values are negative, so we can drop the absolute value with a minus sign in front. You notice here I multiplied across by a minus sign, switching the direction, and solving we get. This time we get x is less than minus 1, but that is inside of the interval that we're in interval 3 here, so the solution set here will go from negative infinity to negative 1 open bracket. So combining these two together, that'll be from negative 1/4 to negative 1/5. And negative infinity to negative 1, we get our answer of negative infinity to negative 1, union negative 1/4 to negative 1/5. All right, that concludes today's lesson on solving rational inequalities with absolute values involved. Thank you.